major commitment that will benefit the public at large. This is part of our societal mission. Back in 2013, the Blavatnik Family Foundation made a major gift to Harvard University for the creation of the Blavatnik Biomedical Accelerator.
The Blavatnik Biomedical Accelerator has enabled our work in three main directions. The first has been to give us the financial freedom to establish a key proof of concept. The second has been to enable us to talk with experts who can help us shape our ideas. And the third has been to connect us with investors and people who might be able to make and realize the commercialization of our work.
Our end goal is to commercialize our developments, ultimately to get these into the hands of patients to impact, have a positive impact on their lives.
Some of the biggest, most impacting ideas are often too early or too risky for industry to take them under their wings. And the Blavatnik program has been extremely helpful in providing the support for that. We are on the cusp of launching a startup, and the startup will focus on developing new therapeutics. So a lot of our friends and family I know have diabetes, and they all take insulin. And patients don't like needles. People are afraid of the needles, and because of that, there is a lot of non-compliance. So we wonder, wouldn't it be nice if we can develop a pill that patients can take to deliver proteins orally? So we developed a technology which can overcome that problem. We showed in the lab that it can be used for insulin, but it can also be used for a number of drugs. For example, antibodies, which are being used for the treatment of cancer, for arthritis. So any drug which is a protein or a peptide, which currently has to be injected, can potentially be delivered orally.
In order to advance them further, create a true partnership between an academic institution and an industrial concern or a startup, you need a source of funding and resources to take them to that point.
The other project that we have in the accelerator is focused on stopping internal bleeding. We developed a solid powder, which you can simply mix in water and inject in the blood. And we developed the technology in the lab. We demonstrated its application, and the Blavatnik project is focused on taking the technology to the next stage by doing some key experiments which are necessary for commercialization of the technology.
Being able to treat patients and save lives is a major motivating factor for myself and my students. We set out to develop a drug that would treat AML, a terrible blood cancer that progresses very quickly and is not treatable in about a third of cases. A member of my extended family has also been, not with AML, but a form of leukemia. Having watched him go through treatment for leukemia, I realized how limited, how few options there are for this kind of disease. We have now established a proof of concept aiming to treat AML by targeting a protein that is currently undruggable. If our ideas are right and everything succeeds, we'll be able to move our molecules into clinical trials in humans. And we wouldn't be able to do this without support from the Blavatnik Foundation.
We are experts in the peripheral nervous system, and many patients with autism spectrum disorders and other disorders experience overreactivity or hypersensitivity to touch or tactile stimuli. They have a hard time getting their hair cut, going to the barber shop, going out in the rain can be quite aversive. And by understanding the neurobiological basis, we can hopefully treat it. And we view this as being potentially valuable not only for autism spectrum disorders, but for other disorders that are associated with touch overreactivity. And that's really where the Blavatnik Biomedical Accelerators come in, guiding us towards the industry partners that we need to bring this to fruition.
Future revenues from the commercialization of technologies that were developed with funding and with support from the accelerator will benefit the fund itself. And we hope that within a short number of years, the Blavatnik Accelerator will become self-sustainable.
We need to establish a key proof of concept before it would be attractive to larger organizations for commercialization. And so the Blavatnik Foundation really fills this hole.
It has connected us with key people surrounding laboratories, and that expertise has also helped in moving the technologies forward.
Blavatnik Biomedical Accelerator has provided support that bridges basic research.
Showing that it can indeed be translated into potential pharmaceutical compound.
We cannot have been successful in what we have done without the vision and commitment of Len Blavatnik, and without the commitment of the Blavatnik Family Foundation.